who's left. In a News 3 Now special report, we take a look at who still needs to get vaccinated on the path to herd immunity and what it's going to take to get there. And one day after announcing his bid for re-election, Governor Evers breaks down what his administration would do with a second term. Plus, a great weekend to be active in southern Wisconsin. A new group is trying to get younger girls outside and on the trails.
This is News 3 Now at 10.
Thanks for joining News 3 Now at 10. I'm Amanda Quintana. A beautiful weekend to get outside, but we do really need some rain. Chief Meteorologist Gary Kenulty joins us now for your certified most accurate forecast. What are the chances we get some thunderstorms to break all this heat up?
Well, a little better than they have been over the last couple of days, but still not as high as we need the chances to be. Let's take a look at the time lapse from the WIC SkyCam. We had clear skies this morning. Some cumulus clouds popped up this afternoon, but they never got to the point where they were thick enough to really generate any rain showers. And you can see as we headed towards sunset, the skies actually started to clear out. There was one little shower that developed north of Rockford, Illinois, and then drifted into southeastern Wisconsin around Lake Geneva, and that was pretty much about it. Low temperatures this morning, very mild. Upper 60s to the lower 70s. High temperatures today, Madison just missed hitting 90 at 89, but Janesville hit 91, La Crosse hit 94, Milwaukee hit 90, and you can see those temperatures are still way up there. Upper 70s, most areas, a few places right around the 80-degree mark. By tomorrow morning, we'll be down to only around 70 degrees, and we should stay dry overnight. Tomorrow we'll see some shower and thunderstorm chances pop up in the afternoon, but the precipitation will be spotty. High temperature at 85. Some areas could get some heavy downpours. Other areas may miss out on the rain altogether. And that pretty much sums up the forecast over the next couple of days. I'll have more details in weather in a few minutes.
Thank you, Gary. And you can stay ahead of this week's storms on our First Warn Forecast weather app. It has hourly forecasts, road conditions, and the latest radar. You can download it for free in your phone's app store. Just search WISC weather. Dr. Anthony Fauci and First Lady Dr. Jill Biden say we're beginning to get back to a pre-pandemic way of life. The two visited a vaccine site in a New York City church in Harlem this afternoon. The church started offering vaccines earlier this year in an effort to boost the vaccination rates in the city's Black and Hispanic communities. But even as life begins to return to normal, health officials say the climb to herd immunity is slowing. And that means there's still a chance for another COVID outbreak. Herd immunity would be when anywhere from 60 to 90% of the population gets vaccinated. But right now, fewer than half of people in Wisconsin have had at least one shot. Madeline O'Neill breaks down who's left to get the vaccine and what's being done to reach them.
I felt like a sprint at the beginning.
In December, it was off to the races for healthcare workers.
Awesome. I'm super excited.
Then the vaccine eligibility gates opened to people 65 and older, some professions such as teachers, and again for those with certain medical conditions.
All right. It was just a little poke.
All adults got the go-ahead in early April, and 16 and 17-year-olds.
My birthday today, it's my 16th birthday. So first thing this morning, I got my first shot.
And finally, 12 to 15-year-olds.
I started squealing and jumping up and down.
But now that enthusiasm is dwindling. And so are the state's vaccination numbers. From a peak of about 426,000 vaccines given in the first full week in April, that's fallen to about 105,000 administered over the last week of May.
It's going to take a little more time now. That's okay. We're in the marathon part.
Moving more slowly along the path to herd immunity, but health leaders are taking steps to get there. They're identifying who's left. Right now, they say it mainly comes down to younger people, communities of color, and people in rural areas.
We all hope to get to a point where COVID doesn't exist.
SSM Health's Mo Carbot says they look to places falling behind, such as Rock, Jefferson, and Dodge counties.
An area where perhaps there aren't many vaccination sites or options out there. And these areas become areas where we need to focus our attention on.
Public health officials are breaking down the data in Dane County, too. The dark blue areas have the lowest rates.
It's not easy when you're in an outlying community all the time, and you might not have access to public transportation.
The data helps determine where to set up pop-up clinics in places such as libraries, even bars and restaurants.
Really trying to reach everywhere, right? All corners of the county.
Fewer Black and Hispanic people have gotten the vaccine, too. Sometimes due to lack of access, sometimes due to hesitancy or mistrust. So Public Health Madison and Dane County is coordinating with trusted community leaders and breaking down information along with barriers.
Not necessarily coming in from a perspective that we're going to come and teach you about the vaccines, but
We are here to listen to your concerns and also share information that is accurate.
I think the majority of this kind of next 40 to 50% of people really are in the willing but need more information.
That includes younger people, some who have gotten caught up in complacency.
And so I think that the combination of I didn't get it yet and things aren't that bad leads to the, well, I guess it's not really that important.
But it is. UW Health's Dr. James Conway says not only to protect themselves, but others, especially against variants.
Is that there is very high likelihood that they have friends and family that actually fit into one of these immune compromised groups that may not get a full response to the vaccine.
Another factor that may make about a third of unvaccinated adults more likely to get vaccinated, full FDA approval, which could come in a few months.
So there are some individuals who are just cautious. And they want to wait.
Some will never opt for the vaccine.
Heels are dug into the sand and they're not moving.
According to the Kaiser Family Foundation, Republicans, rural residents, and white evangelical Christians are more likely to say they will definitely not get vaccinated. So what does that mean for herd immunity? Experts are pacing themselves, focused less on sprinting toward a set finish line and more on adding runners to an ever-growing field.
It's not going to be a light switch, right? It's going to be this dial we're turning up. And we're already turning up that dial, and we're seeing the results already.
In Madison.
Can only go up from here.
Madeline O'Neill, News 3 Now.
Young children will play a major role in reaching herd immunity when they become eligible. You can find more on what doctors say are the next steps to beating the pandemic on our website, channel3000.com. No COVID public health orders are in effect in Dayton County anymore, but public health is still trying to get more shots in arms. PHMDC hosted a pop-up clinic and conversation this afternoon at Centro Hispano in Madison. Organizers say bringing the shots directly to members of our community is one of the easiest ways to get people vaccinated. There's more chances to get a vaccine in our area next week. Public health has four more first dose pop-up clinics planned. The next one Tuesday at District 1 EMS on West Commercial Street in Mazomanie. That's from 3 to 7 o'clock. You can find a full list of pop-up clinics on Public Health Madison Dane County's website. Just a month ago, India was one of the world's COVID hotspots. Today, the country is reporting 114,000 new infections. That's its lowest number in 60 days. It also marks the 10th consecutive day cases dropped below 200,000. The drop comes as the region of Delhi announces it'll ease its COVID restrictions starting tomorrow. We're continuing to follow some breaking news we first brought to you last night. Governor Tony Evers is planning to run for re-election next year. On CNN today, Evers said he feels confident in his chances and he wants to make sure everyone has an equal opportunity to vote.
Our Republicans in Wisconsin are chomping at the bit to make changes in our relatively good election laws. And the good news is I will veto every single one of them that we're in a democracy. We should be hoping to have people vote and not preventing them from voting.
Evers told the Associated Press this weekend he feels his handling of the pandemic saved lives and is the most important work his administration has done. An RNC spokesperson says Evers is out of his mind if he thinks he has a chance at winning in 2022. Meanwhile, Wisconsin Democrats are making their pitches to defeat U.S. Senator Ron Johnson. Each of the five announced candidates addressed the virtual Wisconsin Democratic Convention today. Johnson says he hasn't made up his mind if he plans to seek a third term in office. New tonight, Vice President Kamala Harris is on her way to Guatemala for her first foreign trip since taking office, but her trip wasn't without a scare. Harris's plane, Air Force Two, was forced to make an emergency landing after takeoff at Joint Base Andrews this afternoon. A spokesperson says it was due to a technical issue with the landing gear, but says there were no major safety concerns. President Biden is hoping this is the week he sees some progress on his massive infrastructure bill. But on Friday, the White House rejected another GOP counteroffer. Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg says he still thinks there can be a bipartisan agreement.
A lot of conversations going on among a lot of members of the Senate and over on the House side. On Wednesday, there's going to be a markup for a key element of infrastructure policy. So lots going on right now, but still lots of daylight, honestly, between us and our Republican friends.
Despite all that daylight, Buttigieg is defending Biden's decision to continue talking with Republicans instead of just pushing a deal through the Senate reconciliation process.
In more local news, a summer staple in Madison returned around the city today was the annual Ride the Drive, except instead of being on John Nolan Drive, bikers were spread out at four local parks. Organizers say they plan on having the ride back on John Nolan next year in 2022. It was certainly a perfect day to be on a bike, but as Adam Duxer explains, it can be intimidating for some, especially young girls, to try sports like mountain biking for the first time. We hit the trails to figure out how one group is using a little grit and determination to change that.
It's no surprise on a summer Sunday to see this on a Madison trail.
What's really neat about Madison is that people love to get outside. And they love to do things as a family. Mountain biking in Madison is family friendly.
But to Beth Ross, it's all too often. Not everyone in the family gets a chance to ride.
Yeah, a lot of girls are afraid. They think that mountain biking is what they see on TV. Big jumps, big downhills. And they just think that maybe they're not brave enough or maybe not strong enough to do it. And we're here to tell them they are absolutely strong enough and brave enough.
Today, Ross and a team of coaches did just that, giving close to 50 girls between the ages of 12 and 18, even some who didn't own a bike, a chance to learn. All part of a national initiative to get more girls involved in the sport.
The name of our organization is GRIT. It stands for Girls Riding Together. And I think that mountain biking, especially girls, is about grit, is about trying something new, doing something hard, making lots of mistakes, but still getting back on your bike after making those mistakes, because that's what makes you better.
Ross's daughter, Sarah, says it's not as tough as it looks.
I would say just get out and try it. That's really, I guess, my advice, because I think it's just so much fun.
And even if today is the only time these girls try the sport, the hope is the lessons learned will go far beyond the trail.
If I can empower girls to do things that they didn't think they could do, to me it just carries that on to so many different parts of their lives. Who knows what and where it will take those girls.
In Madison, Adam Duxter, News 3 Now.
Any riders who missed out on today's lessons can find more chances to ride on madisonmtb.org. When life hands you lemons, one Fitchburg girl literally made lemonade. Next at 10, the reason she's setting up a stand in front of her house this weekend. Plus, with minicamp just 2 days away, still no word on if Aaron Rodgers will show up. The latest from Green Bay. That's ahead in sports.
If a nurse is what you want to be, let Herzing University make it possible in lots of different ways. Whether you're planning to become a nurse for the first time or take your nursing career to the next level, Herzing offers learning options and a choice of nursing pathways, all with personal care and support. We'll even waive your enrollment fee. Be exactly the nurse you want to be.
I'm possible at Herzing.
I'm possible at Herzing.
I'm possible at Herzing.
I'm possible at Herzing.
Call or click today.
With Dad's arthritis, he needs extra help around the house, so I called a Grace. Yes, a Grace. With their agent home service, he can stay at home.
That's where I want to spend these months. With hospice care from a Grace, I can stay home with my dog and my grandkids and their laughter.
I had no idea laughter could be a part of my life again after Joe died, but through a Grace, I found hope and healing.
A Grace, caring every step of the way.
No more Freon for your AC. Oh no, the homeowner's called Action Man and his action team.
Call on Action Plumbing, Heating, and Electric at iwantactionnow.com.
Is your credit score getting in the way of things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit help you borrow up to $10,000. So check your eligibility on netcredit.com today without affecting your credit score. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal loan.
At Pick and Save, we go over and above to make sure we have the freshest stuff in our stores. That's why we get secret shoppers to do pop inspections.
Secret Asian man, secret Asian man.
We make sure Pick and Save produce isn't just fresh, it's fresher than fresh. Pick and Save, fresh for everyone.
A healthy mouth is the gateway to a healthy body.
That's why we designed Quip electric toothbrushes for adults and kids, toothpaste, and refillable floss that keep you healthy. Quip's simple features help guide a better oral care routine, with refills delivered every 3 months from $5. And if you want more bang for your brush, make it smart to get rewards as you track and coach better brushing. Make better oral health simple, affordable, and enjoyable at getquip.com.
Hey folks, Monday morning we are at a specialized training gym that's opening up here in the 608, Russell Wandering Wisconsin, and taking a look at everything there is to do in lacrosse. Join us between 4:30 and 7 for News 3 Now this morning.
You're watching News 3 Now at 10.
Welcome back. The sunny weather this weekend may have given people the idea to cool down with some ice-cold lemonade. So 9-year-old girl from Fitchburg set up a stand right in front of her house. As photojournalist Anna Hansen shows us, she's also showing her resilience at a young age.
Today might have been the perfect day for a lemonade stand. This one is for a cause especially close to Megan's heart.
I really love animals, so I want to help them get a good home.
She's been raising money for the Dane County Humane Society since May, doing chores for neighbors. Then her efforts were interrupted.
It's $25, and it all got stolen in a robbery.
Her family's home was broken into on Tuesday, along with tablets and keys. The money Megan worked so hard for was taken.
You can learn a lot from your kids about, you know, literally making lemonade from lemons.
Without missing a beat, she jumped right back into fundraising, trying to meet her goal of $250 to help at least 5 dogs get ready for adoption.
That if you, like, raise $50, they can get a spray and get all their fleas.
Showing that you can always sweeten a sour situation.
Megan reached her goal of $250 today through her lemonade stand and online donations. If you'd still like to help out, we have a link on our website, channel3000.com. Somber ceremonies at an American cemetery in France today. It's the 77th anniversary of the D-Day landings, when more than 150,000 Allied troops landed on beaches in Normandy. More than 4,400 Allied troops died that day, 2,500 of them Americans. For the second year in a row, commemorations were smaller because of travel restrictions preventing veterans or families of fallen soldiers from the U.S., Britain, Canada, and other Allied countries from making the trip to France. Let's get a look at your certified most accurate forecast with Gary Kenalty. Gary, that weather forecast for the D-Day invasion had to be so important.
Probably one of the most important weather forecasts in history. And when you think about it, I mean, basically, they were the last people to say whether or not the invasion could even take place. And you think about it. No weather satellite, no weather radar, limited weather observations over Europe. The Nazis certainly weren't going to share their weather observations with the Allies, and very limited observations over the ocean as well, just a few ship reports. So in this forecast, first of all, had to be the D-Day invasion had to be delayed by a day because of a fierce storm on the 5th of June, which was when they originally had planned to do the invasion, so they postponed it by a day. The meteorologist, the Royal Air Force meteorologist, said marginal weather for the 6th, just barely enough to do the invasion. And the weather decision for General Eisenhower was the final go or no go decision. And when they said go, the invasion was on. And here's one of the weather maps from the Royal Air Force. This is the day before the D-Day invasion, June 5th, 1944, showing a big, strong cold front sweeping through the English Channel with high waves, high winds, a lot of rain. And so they had postponed the invasion. They had even started sending ships out and they had to call them back. But for the 6th, they had forecast there was going to be a little area of clearing as the storm system lifted to the north, and that allowed some clearing to come in from the west, gave them marginal conditions. The winds were still stronger than they wanted, but at least it allowed them to invade Nazi Germany. They did not think the Allies would invade, and that also helped with the invasion. Of course, the rest, as we say, is history. Three things you need to know in the forecast. Warm weather will will continue this week with highs in the mid to upper 80s. Humidity levels will also increase, though, and that will give us some shower and thunderstorm chances, mainly in the afternoon and evening. But precipitation amounts will be spotty. Some areas will pick up heavy downpours. Other areas nearby may miss out on the rain altogether. On Doppler track, a little tiny sprinkle moved into southeastern Wisconsin, and that was pretty much about it. Over the last 5 days, very little rain has fallen. Most areas not even seeing any rain at all, but even the areas that got rain saw less than a quarter of an inch of rain. Future track precipitation through Wednesday noon. Spotty precipitation over southern Wisconsin. Some areas may pick up an inch or two. Some areas may not pick up anything. It's hard to say exactly who will get it and who won't. But even looking out for the whole 10-day period through the middle of next week, we're still in general looking for about a quarter to maybe an inch of rain across southern Wisconsin. Live view from the Edgewater Sky Cam. High today 89, the low temperature a muggy 72. And for tomorrow, I'm looking for a high temperature of 85. It'll be very warm, a little more humid with some afternoon shower and thunderstorm chances. You can see this on Future Track beginning at noon tomorrow. A few showers and storms popping up in the afternoon. Again, some areas heavy downpours, other areas not seeing any rain at all. The rain pretty much over with by midnight. Then we'll stay quiet overnight, and then some more showers and storms popping up in the afternoon on Tuesday. We'll repeat the process for Wednesday Thursday. Rainfall amounts spotty, some areas getting heavy amounts, other areas not getting anything. Hopefully all of us will at least get some rain this week, because as you can see in the extended forecast, the temperatures stay warm, but the humidity levels drop, and that means the rain chances go away. Maybe a slight chance Saturday, but after that, dry weather at least through the middle of next week, and that's not doing well for our drought conditions.
Yeah, and it seems like there are some areas that could just get no rain.
That's
some
very areas possible.
So I guess we'll see what happens as the week goes on. Thank you so much, Gary. Forward Madison is back home and looking to continue its hot streak. Jordan has highlights coming up next in sports.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Here in the Midwest, community is important.
Having a healthcare system that's looking out for us,
that's actively addressing the racial disparities in healthcare, is important.
When we can get good quality care, we can do more. We can achieve more.
We can be the kind of community we want to be, and that's really important.
UW Health. Remarkable medicine. Remarkable care.
Your first home is the start of realizing bigger dreams with your family. That's why it's important to protect everything you love with American Family Insurance. Wait, what's that?
It's their dream car.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. It's actually my dream car, and my little dream tire swing with some dream trees. There'd be a nice dream garden right here, too.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance.
Insure carefully, dream fearlessly.
American Family Insurance.
Can you get this? I don't have my wallet.
Oh, really? It's funny how that always happens.
Yeah, it's funny.
With BMO Harris, you don't need your wallet. You can get money from any BMO ATM using your phone.
Uh-oh, looks like someone can buy their own tacos.
You could also pay them back with Zelle.
So many ways for you to pay.
Awesome.
Order for BMO.
Ooh, tacos, banking. Some things are made to be mobile.
That feeling you get when your phone is your wallet, that's the BMO effect. And right now, open a new BMO Harris account online in just 5 minutes.
Now's the time to get a Ford built for you, by you.
Pick your color, your wheels, and other available features specifically designed for your Ford. Want an F-150 with a 12-inch touchscreen, 400 horsepower in an Explorer, or a moonroof? You've got it. And now an additional $1,000 bonus cash on top of all public offers. See your dealer for a Ford built for you, by you. Build and order your select Ford today and get $1,000 bonus cash in addition to all public offers.
And off to a hot start this season, actually their best in team history. Right now, the Flamingos sit second in the USL League One standings with no losses. The Mingos back at Breeze Stevens Field to face Union Omaha, a team they shut out almost 2 weeks ago. In the seventh minute, Owls strike. Lots of traffic in front of the net, and Omaha scores on an own goal. Now, nearing halftime, Jake Keegan buries the equalizer. First time this season the Mingos scored in the first half. The score holds into the second, where Omaha gets the go-ahead. Ford Madison falls 2-1, their first loss of the year. Mingos back at it next Saturday. Brewers bringing their brooms to AmFam Field today, going for a four-game sweep of the Diamondbacks. Pitcher's duel keeps the bats quiet until the fifth. Daniel Robertson takes it to deep left, his second homer of the season. Crew adds another run in the sixth, courtesy of a Tyrone Taylor home run. But a big storyline in this game, Corbin Burnes, absolutely dealing. Seven shutout innings, a career-high 13 strikeouts. Brewers blank the D-backs 2-0. Mallard's hoping to slide back into the win column this afternoon, a matinee meeting with the pit spitters. Nine innings, not enough. This one goes to the 10th, tied at four, where the Mallards walk it off and win it 5-4. Game two of the series is tomorrow at 6:05. And Bucks coming off their first loss of the postseason. After a fast and physical one with the Nets, it's time to regroup and make adjustments for game two, which includes tweaking things on both sides of the ball. Bucks very aware they struggled to knock down shots and didn't make it as tough for the Nets as they hoped. Giannis drew some comparisons between this game and their game one with the Heat. Maybe a similar equation, but different results. Either way, he says the key to getting over the Brooklyn bump is playing together.
Keep playing together and keep touching one another. I think that's going to be the key for us. And I hope we're going to shoot the ball better. You never know what's going to happen, but I hope that going to game two, we're going to shoot the ball better as a team. Hopefully we can make more threes, play better defense, and give ourselves a chance to win the game.
Nets will be without James Harden again for game two, which is set for tomorrow night at the Barclays Center. Tip-off is at 6:30. And the Packers are just days away from their mandatory minicamp. The question on everyone's mind, will Aaron Rodgers show up? The situation between him and the team is dividing fans, according to Packers president Mark Murphy. Murphy's monthly column dropped this weekend, and one of the first things he addresses is Rodgers, adding that the team is committed to resolving things, and they want him back, something that Matt LaFleur has also said over the last couple of weeks. In the meantime, Jordan Love has been getting first team reps, had his first dose of 11-on-11 action this past week. Now, I feel like fans are just going to be holding their breath on Tuesday to see what happens and if Aaron Rodgers will show up.
Yeah, and this whole saga, it feels like we haven't really gotten many answers. We've gotten the Packers saying we want him to stay.
There's probably more questions than answers right now.
I want to know what's going on.
Okay. You and many others.
And so many others, I'm sure. Thank you so much. We'll be right back.
This is a Wisconsin farmer. She grows the locally sourced freshness, the freshness that complements the wild-caught salmon that tees up the cheesecake that sweetens every moment. Festival Foods, we are Wisconsin.
Is it possible to fall in love with your home? To get goosebumps in the driveway? Is it possible for your home to withstand nor'easters and help protect you from fire? You feel like home. Is it possible to fall in love with your home before you even step inside?
Discover the world of exterior solutions by James Hardy. Endless colors, textures, and design. It's possible with James Hardy.
Okay, guys, we've been through a lot together. We all know sometimes it gets hard, but it's okay to not feel okay. You know what helps? A good book or going for a walk. Not now, Fred. But what really helps is to talk to someone. Because to take care of each other, you gotta take care of you. If you need to talk to someone, your doctor will listen.
Unity Point Health Meritor, a partner of UW Health. Know how much you matter to this world.
The only thing better than tacos is faster tacos. That's why Johnsonville created its new ground taco sausage. That's right, taco sausage. Premium cuts of ground pork authentically seasoned with cumin and garlic. Next taco night, skip the seasoning packets. Just sizzle and serve. Because with new Johnsonville taco sausage, the only thing between your family and tasty tacos is 10 minutes.
Turn up the radio and discover all that Illinois has to offer. Find your road trip at enjoyillinois.com.
Dear road rivals, every new Toyota comes with Toyota Care, our no-cost maintenance plan that covers tire rotations, engine oil changes, fluid adjustments, and more for 2 years or 25,000 miles. Ford charges extra for maintenance. Nissan charges extra for maintenance. And you guessed it, Honda charges extra for maintenance. At Toyota, we take care of our drivers. Too bad none of our rivals do the same. Join us, Toyota. Let's go places.
This is a Wisconsin brewmaster. He brews the local craft beer, the beer that washes down the Oktoberfest brat, the brat that pairs with the potato salad that befriends the burger that tastes like victory. Festival Foods, we are Wisconsin.
Join me in the 608 weekdays on News 3 Now this morning.
You're watching News 3 Now at 10.
It was a beautiful day. I don't often hope for rain, but we need some rain.
Yeah, the grass is starting to look brown.
Yes. You
know, that's a telltale sign there. And take a look at Doppler track across the upper Midwest. you don't
Where's
see anything
the rain?
There. Yeah. These temperatures would be fine if they were daytime high temperatures this time of year, but at 10 o'clock at night, that's pretty sultry. Look for a low tonight of about 70. Maybe some thunderstorms for some of us tomorrow afternoon with a high of 85. Pretty much the same story the next few days. Temperatures stay warm, but the humidity goes down and the rain chances go away for next week.
All right. Thanks so much for joining us. Have a great night.